together, 3 years really going out. How do you feel? Bernard, Marta, Matthias, how do you feel? Florian?
Tired.
Tired? I feel tired as well. But I can promise you, we are nearly there. So we were going out, meeting people, asking them what they wanted to know, and it felt right. It just felt right, it felt strong. We were meeting people who were just pushing the idea of an energy-efficient music culture. And how weird is that idea? Can creativity ever be efficient? Can we talk to people whose business is growing, burning, thriving, whose business comes out of an idea of abundance? Can we talk to them about scarcity, about resources which are not there forever? So we are moving into an industry, into a sector which comes from a mindset out of infinity, an infinite resource, creativity. And we were talking about finite resources. But we were realizing it made sense, because it's not about saving energy. It's about using energy the better way. Because we can't save energy. There's no way of saving energy. Energy is just there, but you have to make good use of it. And all of a sudden that project grew, and wherever we came, Norway in the north, Greece in the south, Bulgaria in the east, Portugal in the west, it all came together. We were realizing it was there. It made sense, and it made so much sense. But more than that, we were realizing whenever we started to talk about efficiency, at a very early stage, discussion moved into other areas, I have to say. So when we talked about energy efficiency in Iceland, they said, well, obviously that's not our problem. We have enough energy. And I don't know if anybody has been to Iceland. When you go to Iceland and you put a stick into the ground, wherever hot water comes spurtling out, so they have an abundance of energy. Exactly, so they have too much energy. So talk to someone who has too much energy from renewable sources about energy efficiency. That's weird. Then we were in Poland, and we were meeting people from Poland, where we like, we want to do that, but our government is really against it. So it was weird. So we had people being really passionate about that, being really passionate about the European idea, and they had a government which had really nothing at all on mind with energy efficiency. Yeah, we went to Hungary, a lovely country, but it's really hard to talk in a country which is on the verge of a fascist regime, talk about energy efficiency. Because when you talk to people from the creative industry, they are feeling it. They are feeling it. And Denmark, and the Netherlands, so wherever we went, energy efficiency was just the start of the discussion. But we met people there. And during that journey, over the last 3 years, we've been producing so much legacy, reports, handbooks, films, awards. We were communicating, we're disseminating the idea. Like you saw with the Eurovision Song Contest, Europe's biggest TV event, world's biggest TV entertainment event, done energy efficiently. How could a European project have a better ending than that? And I am really happy now, because we had a workshop today, Edison and me, and I had the feeling we've gone all the way from the one to the end. Our job is done now. We reached it, we've gone full circle. Everything is there for you to take it from there. And in that moment, which we're about to finish that project, let's for a moment think of the people we lost on the way, or which left us, who's left us. Let's think about Claire from Julie's Bicycle. Without Claire, there would have been no EE music. Let's think about Alexander. Without Alexander, even if it was a pain in the ass, there would have been no EE music, I think. Yeah, let's think about Nina. Nina left me, and with her, it wouldn't be as it is. And let's think about Elena with United Partners. We have to save them, even if they're not here. They are as part as we are. But before we really leave and party and celebrate, before we do that, I'm so proud to say, not only is our job done, while doing so, we identified ambassadors. We identified people like you, Vilma, people like you, Beatrice, people in Iceland, people in the Netherlands, people in Romania, Bulgaria, everywhere, who are ready to take the spark. They're ready to take the spark and take it from there. It is yours. EE Music is a project founded by the European Commission with just one reason, one objective, and that objective to really give everything to you. It is about energy efficiency, but more than that, it's about understanding of us Europeans. I learned so much about Europe in the last 3 years. I learned something about energy efficiency, but even more about Europe. And it was a pain in the ass, I can tell you, Zoe. If you have to work with a consortium, which exists of like 5 different companies from 5 different countries, you want to start the project. I want to do it on my own, it's easier, it's quicker. But yeah, we made our way through. It's a European project, and we had to learn the language. We had to learn an Esperanto, a language everybody understands in all of Europe. And in between, I had the feeling, where are we going? Is it going to stop ever? But now, we are there. That is the moment. The project is about to end. Our project is about to end. And we're handing over the project to our ambassadors. Everywhere, in all of Europe, we have you and we thank you. So we had the idea. We had the spark. Now the tree is there. Everything is for you to use. Take it. Take the handbooks, take the ideas, and take it from there. And remember, from now on, you are the one, and the one is you. Thank you.